Now, in general, orbits will look pretty much like this, especially the orbits of like planets in the solar system. They will look like ellipses. And I know that many of you should be familiar with ellipses. There's different ways you can write an ellipse mathematically with Cartesian coordinates or using the sum of r and r prime being two times the major axis. So all the definitions are given here. You can also find them in the lecture notes with all the details. But just to make sure that everyone is on board, and you can always skip parts of the video if you already know, let's go back to the whiteboard and just make sure we define all the points that you can see around here. Well, first thing we need to do is clear the board. And if we want to look at an ellipse, well, number one, you should have artistic skills, which are better than mine. So I apologize for that. You might remember it from physics 101. I'm not the best at drawing, but I try. And we can think of an ellipse, something that looks sort of like this. Just go along with it. And this is just so that you understand or recap all the definitions. And we have one of the focus or foci here, the other one on the other side. This is important. For Kepler's laws, it is assumed, for example, that the sun is here, the other one is empty, and the planets just go around. And for Kepler's laws, for our planets, this would be quite a big exaggeration. Now, it is important to understand that this distance, this is the semi-major axis. This is what we call A, and here, this is B. This is the semi-minor axis. And the distance from here to here is actually given as A times E, where E is the eccentricity. And you can very easily see that E, if E equals zero, then this distance becomes zero, and F becomes the same as F prime or the other focus, and an ellipse just becomes a circle. The other thing that's important to understand, and this will come in handy later on when we actually define coordinates. Let's say this point over here. The way that you can draw an ellipse very easily is if you define these two distances, calling this r and this r prime. And we'll see that the angle that we're going to be talking about is theta. And the definition that we saw is that you can actually explain or define all these points of a specific ellipse if you look at points that satisfy this condition, r prime plus r equals 2a. These are the points that are defined in this specific ellipse. And we'll come back to this when we define an equation that will essentially tell you the position from. So this is important because r will be the distance from the focus. This is where we're going to have our astronomical objects, such as the sun or the Earth, and this is the angle that we're going to use. So in practice, we'll be able to use polar coordinates, remember, from Phys 101. This will come at handy. So I think my work is done for now. Let's go back to the slides. Now we've seen on the whiteboard, and we've defined all these points that you see here. So I think we can move along. And actually, just to make sure that you understand all the definitions that are left here on the slides, and also you will find them in the lecture notes. If you have any questions, please just let me know. But all the things that you can find here, we covered them in the whiteboard already. Now let's come back to the important condition. We saw that r prime plus r must equal 2a to describe a point in the ellipse, as you see right here. The advantage of this is that there is a specific special point where r prime equals r. So we can see that special point right here. Now, because at that specific point, r prime equals r, this means 2r equals 2a, and therefore r at that point equals the semi-major axis A. And we can also see some simple geometrical conditions that you could derive for this, and that may come in handy to deal with the eccentricity
and also the relations between the semi-major axis and the semi-minor axis. What we actually want to do is, as I told you on the whiteboard, it is quite useful if we define the position in an elliptical orbit using polar coordinates. They make your life much easier than trying to use X and Y. And we've already seen the definition, but we're going to be using is this theta over here, with R being the distance from the prime focus, which is where typically the objects with mass will be. So the question is, how do we do it in practice? All you have to do is, let's start trying to define this R prime in terms of X and Y that you can very easily read. And you'll see geometrically from looking just at the diagram that the X coordinates is simply given by AE plus AE plus R cos theta. And that's essentially to get you all the way over here. And the Y coordinates is very simply given by R sine theta. So in this case, it's just R sine theta. In other words, you can think that you're looking at R cos theta over here and R sine theta. The only difference is because we're looking at R prime, we actually have to add quantity over here. So finally, what we are going to try to do, and you have all the details in the lecture notes, is to show that in polar coordinates, the location in terms of R, which is what we're going to use, is given by this. And you can very easily go through it, but there are two important main steps. So one is to write just the equation of an ellipse with R plus R prime equals 2a, and you can re-express it and then go to the expression that we had before and just sub in. And all the other steps are just to do with essentially substituting and then grouping terms such as sines and cosines. I actually left all the details so you can reproduce it. And ultimately, you'll be able to find the expression that we're going to use that is going to be fundamental, not only to describe orbits geometrically, but also this is what we're going to be using when we connect ellipses with some physics like angular momentum. If you do have any questions about the derivation, just get in touch. I can go through it as well on the whiteboard, but you have all the details apart from here in the slides, also in the lecture notes.